Hi everyone, this is Sherry from Planning Peep and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing my memory spread and it's for the week of July 30th through August 5th. I'm really behind in my planning right now. I'm about 3 weeks behind and so I have a lot to catch up on. Today is actually already the 18th of August and so as you can see, I haven't done any planning for the last couple weeks and part of it was because we were out of town on a road trip and then as soon as I got back, I pretty much started work right away. So just like settling into the work routine and everything has taken up a lot of my time. But anyways, this week was actually really exciting because it marked the first week of our road trip. We left on this Friday, so I have a really gorgeous travel themed kit from Paper Blush Bar that I purchased specifically for this week. And it's called Darling Adventures. It does have a holographic foil, and unfortunately I don't really own anything in like hollow foil, so I have only a couple of foiled items that I can pull in, which are these ones from Student Planning and then these stickers from Hey Soul Sticker. So these are the only non-gold foil stickers I have, so I'll be trying to pull those in when I can. I also have this Simply Gilded washi that I got quite a long time ago, but this is hollow foil, so I'm gonna try to pull these in as headers. But anyways, here we have the 8 full boxes. We've got the bottom washi, washi strips, and a sidebar tracker. We have half boxes, icons, flags, and then the habit trackers, as well as a very small and dainty weekend banner. On this page, we have all the headers, we have date covers, heart checklists, some third boxes, flags, and then I think these are just washi strips. And the last page here are the check boxes, which I think are so pretty with these little travel themed pictures in the background. So yeah, I'm going to start by placing down my bottom washi and I decided I'm going to trim off just a little bit and then layer the hollow washi strip over it. So hopefully I can bring in a little bit more foiling. So if you're interested in watching me plan, stay tuned. Sorry for the rather long intro. I think I was just feeling really chatty when I filmed this. But like I mentioned, I am placing down that washi strip first at the top and then I trimmed down the bottom washi. It was super dumb because I didn't realize that the bottom washi was already cut into two strips so that you could use just half of it if you didn't want the whole thing. And so when I trimmed it, it turned into four strips. So that's why you're seeing me place down two of the smaller strips in order to make the bottom washi. Hopefully that kind of made sense, but I should have just like taken a closer look and realized that it was already pre-trimmed. Anyways, moving on to the sidebar, I chose the quote box as my top corner box, of course, and that quote is foiled, so I think it's super gorgeous. And then I placed down all of my date covers that came with the kit. The kit didn't come with any date dots, and I couldn't find anything that would match this very dainty style of the kit, and so I just ended up writing in the dates myself. Moving back to my sidebar, I put down a This Week header underneath the full box, and then I used a habit tracker to track working out. The shoe sticker is from Panda Bird Designs. I placed down a quarter box or maybe a washi strip, I can't really tell, to mark all my happy moments, and also used a heart checklist. The silver foiled heart sticker is from Student Planning. At the bottom, I used a Don't Forget header with the Monday through Sunday tracker to track my dinners for the week. Then moving on to Monday, I started by putting down a today header and then I used a half box to mark that we had to say goodbye to our cat Pokey. Because she's not coming on the road trip with us, my boyfriend's mom came by to pick her up so that she could take care of her while we were gone. The Maru sticker with the cat is from Paper and Milk. And then I also used a crying emoji from the Coffee Monsters Co. because it was so sad to say goodbye to her. I moved to the bottom and put down a full box because I knew I wanted a full box at the bottom of the day. And then moving back, I used a quarter box with a silver foiled boba sticker from Hey Soul Sticker to mark that we got some boba that day. And then I went shopping because I was attending a wedding the following weekend and I had nothing to wear, so I needed to find a dress. The Shopping Girl sticker is from Paper Princess Plans, and the Shopping Day sticker or the Shopping Day heart is from Thule Plans. I then used a strip of the washi as a header and I put down a quarter box that I found from my collection. The planner sticker came in the kit and I used that to mark that I journaled that day, and then at the end of the night we watched some TV. We were still really into the show called Hiyori's Bed and Breakfast that I talked about in my last plan with me. It's super cute, and the TV sticker originally was from the kit but I replaced it with one from Brandy's shop. Then for Tuesday, I started by putting down a strip of washi at the top, and then I used a happy birthday sticker from, I think it's from my Peachy Printables, to mark that it's Harry Potter's birthday. The Harry Potter marshmallow sticker is from Paper and Milk, and I love that Harry Potter sheet. It's so cute. But anyways, I really wanted to mark that. On Tuesday, my boyfriend and I drove down to hang out with a friend who's also on summer break because she works in a school as well. And so I used I think it's a quarter box with a car sticker from the kit. And I put down the full box and cut off just the bottom of it because I wanted to make sure I had enough space to mark everything that I wanted. I used a strip of the washi that came in the kit and wrote adventures over that because I wanted to mark all the places that we went while we were there. We basically just bar hopped around, and so I just marked the places that we went, and then also used a beer sticker from Dizzy Daisy Dreams. I then used a quarter box with a heart to location tag sticker from Simply Laura to mark that we watched the sunset by the beach, and it was so beautiful. It's definitely something that I don't do enough. Despite living quite close to the beach, I don't make it out there very often, so that's definitely something I want to strive to do more. Then because it's Tuesday, of course we had to do Taco Tuesday, so I put down a taco sticker from Plans with the Nest to mark that, and that's pretty much it. We drove home after that, and overall it was a really, really fun day. On Wednesday, I started by placing down a full box at the top. Then I used a strip of washi with a meal icon from Bubba Bear Studios to mark that I cooked breakfast that morning. I made some green onion pancakes, which are really good. And then I used a header. I think it might say goals or to-do or something. I can't really read it from here. And also used a two-heart checklist to mark some places that I went. I used a Target Run sticker from Love Shira because that was one of the spots we went to. And then we also did some groceries at a Korean market. So I placed down a grocery icon from the kit. Wednesday was my big laundry day because I definitely wanted to wash everything before we went on the trip. So I placed down a half box, and the really cute laundry sticker is from Dizzy Daisy Dreams. Then after that, I put down a TV icon from the kit, the one I lifted up from Monday, and marked that we watched this show called Kim's Convenience, which was a new find that we absolutely loved. It's a Canadian show about a Korean-Canadian family that owns a convenience store. It's a really funny show, so I definitely would highly recommend it. It's also on Netflix, so that makes it easy. And anyways, at the end of the night, I got some Happy Mail from Amazon, so I went to go pick it up, and then the Happy Mail sticker is from Very Jenny Co. On Thursday, I started by putting down a full box at the bottom because I knew that's where I wanted it, and then I used a strip of the washi as a header on top. Then I moved back to the top and I started by putting down a today header, and then I used a half box to mark that we had lunch in Long Beach that day. We were meeting up with some family, so it was really fun to see them. The burger sticker is from Dizzy Daisy Dreams. We also went and got some ice cream afterwards, and this place was so amazing. It was like one of those like craft ice cream places that has like really interesting and unique flavors, so that was a really fun experience. The Emoti ice cream sticker is from the Coffee Monsters Co. I then decided to work backwards because I wanted to see how much space there was to fit things. So the first thing I did was place down a quarter box that I found in my collection, and over that I used a house sticker from a shop that's no longer opened to mark that we had a friend staying over that night and he got in pretty late, so that was the last thing I wanted to mark. And above that I put a burger sticker from Paper and Milk to mark that we got some In-N-Out that day for dinner. I didn't like the way that I wrote In-N-Out, so I whited it out, and then when I rewrote it, the pen kind of like bled and I didn't like how it looked. So I ended up writing it on the corner of the kit where there was like white space, and I just stuck it on top. I then placed down a quarter box with a beer girl sticker from Kina Prince to mark that we went to a brewery. And then in the remaining space that I had left, I used a record sticker from Love Shira. Originally, the microphone's on the left of the record lettering, but because I wanted it on the right-hand side, I just cut it off and then placed it on the right. And I think that turned out really cute. Moving on to Friday, I placed down a strip of the washi at the top, and then I used a suitcase sticker from Sticker Blush to mark that I was packing for my trip on Friday. I definitely had a lot to pack because the trip was going to be like 10 days long, and so I definitely had to take into consideration all the activities that we were going to be doing and pack accordingly. So anyways, then we grabbed lunch at a really delicious soba place with my friend that had stayed over the night before, so I put that on a half box, and the noodle sticker is from A Happy Blue Tree. On Friday, I placed down the full box with the van because since that's the day we left for a road trip, I felt like that was super appropriate. Underneath the full box, I put down an important label or like an important header, and then I cut up a heart checklist to mark some things that I got done. Originally, I placed down 4 checklists, and then I decided I didn't have enough space to mark things that I wanted, so I just changed it to 3 checklists instead. So that evening, we set out on our road trip, which is really exciting. The first stop was actually my boyfriend's parents' house, and so it was just perfect because it was on the way, and I also got to see Pokey for the night. So to mark all that, I used a heart location tag sticker from Simply Laura, or I think that one's from Sunset Sticker Co., and then the emoji with a cat sticker is from the Coffee Monsters Co. Then moving to the weekend, I placed down a strip of the thin washi across the top, and then I put down the weekend banner that came in the kit. I love how it's so dainty and beautiful. On Saturday, I first placed down the full box with the suitcase. Again, I just feel like that's so appropriate for the trip. And then I used a quarter box with a burrito sticker from Plants with Finesse because we stopped by a gas station for gas that morning when we left for our next destination, and I grabbed a burrito from there, and it was the best burrito I've ever had. It was like so amazing, and so I definitely had to mark that. And then the road trip sticker that I put down is from Hello Petite Paper. Our second stop was in Berkeley, which is in the Bay Area, so I got to see my sister for the night, which is really exciting. When we got there, we just kind of hung out with my sister for a bit, and the silver heart sticker again is from Student Planning. I then had a really hard time placing down all the things that I wanted because the half box was taking up a lot of space. What I ended up doing was I just trimmed the outside of the half box so that it was a little bit shorter, I guess, and so I could fit something underneath it. But anyways, I used a strip of washi to mark where we got dinner that night. We went to a Tibetan place, and I've never really tried Tibetan food before, so that was a really exciting experience. The meal icon actually came in the kit, and then on the half box, I marked that we watched my sister's concert that day. I was super proud of her because she did such an amazing job. The musical notes sticker is from Plans with Finesse, and then the cheerleader girl sticker is from Artbox Stickers. And then after the concert, we all went and got some beers and late night foods at Eureka, which is a burger place, and it was super good. They also had happy hour, which was perfect. The beer sticker is from Paper and Milk. For Sunday, I started by placing down a full box at the bottom because I knew that's where I wanted it. And then moving back to the top, I started by putting down a flag from the kit with a noodle sticker from Sticker Oki because we went and got some pho in the morning before we headed out for our next destination. I do end up switching out the noodle sticker because it was just so large, and the car sticker that I placed down underneath it also was really large, so I just didn't want those two stickers competing with each other. The car sticker that I placed down is from Simply Me Kish, and I think it's so cute. I purchased them specifically for the road trip, and that noodle sticker I ended up replacing was from A Happy Blue Tree. Our next stop was in Ashland, Oregon, and the drive there was honestly so beautiful, but it was unfortunate because there was a fire burning somewhat nearby, so it definitely created a ton of smoke in the area, but you know, you can't really control that. So we just tried to take it all in regardless. Once we got to Ashland, again, unfortunately, it was really, really ashy on that day. Ashland is known for their Shakespeare festivals, and the air was so bad that they had to cancel their shows for the night because I think it's an outdoor theater. So we definitely didn't get the full experience. So hopefully we'll get a chance to go back one day and see more of what the city has to offer. But anyways, we did end up going to a couple breweries and stuff like that. So I placed down a small strip of washi. I wrote remember on it. And then I placed down a 3 heart checklist to mark the place that we visited. At the end of the night, we went back to our Airbnb, which in Ashland was this cute little camper that was in the backyard of someone's house. It was so adorable and like super tiny, but perfect for the night. So I used a little strip of washi and used this board game sticker from Paper and Milk to mark that we went back to our camper, we had some more beers, and then played some games that they had. So it was just kind of a super chill night, but it was definitely very memorable. I move back to the sidebar and track my workouts, my happy moments, and dinners for the week. And I definitely had a ton of happy moments that I wanted to include, but I only had space for 5, so I really had to limit it to some of my favorites from the week. So that is pretty much it for this week. I'm just zooming out so you can see the spread in full, and also giving you guys a Viv wiggle to see all the pretty foil that was in the kit. And now I'm just showing you the stickers that I have left. I definitely have a ton of stickers left, but I'm just adding it to my pile of leftover of stickers that eventually I want to give away. So anyways, that is how my spread turned out, and I think this is so beautiful. I'm obsessed with this kit, and I'm so glad that I got it for this week. I'm also really loving planning out these summer memories, because now that school is fully back in session, it's just such a good reminder of all the fun adventures that I had over the summer. And this is actually the second to last summer spread, because the next spread I do is going to be the remainder of our road trip, and then the following week I start work. So we're almost at the end of my summer spreads. Hope you guys are enjoying these. And if you have any questions, leave them down below. Thank you so much for watching. As always, I appreciate all the support that I get from you guys. And yeah, I will talk to you in my next video. Bye.